وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم.
Allah is Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the especially merciful, as mentioned on 93 instances in the Quran and 112 times in Bismillah. Ar-Rahim is who grants us even more blessings and greater rewards in response to our good actions and pious thoughts. The one who greatly rewards those who use divine blessings in an excellent way. The one who has mercy on those who are merciful to others. He loves to forgive and forgives in such a way which benefits the individual. Ar-Rahim as an attribute signifies a relation between Allah and the object of mercy. It is the mercy that is always there, but not necessarily being used by Allah at the very moment. This mercy can be seen on humans, animals, nature, and everything else in creation. But how can we receive the special mercy in our life? We will investigate the Quran in order to find ways to do so. By obeying Allah, and let the Quran be your guide. It says in the Quran, He is the one who showers His blessings upon you, and His angels pray for you, so that He may bring you out of the darkness and into light. For He is ever merciful to the believers. Allah repeatedly mentions in the Quran how to receive this special mercy. Another instance is, Obey Allah and the Messenger so you may be shown mercy. We must also have taqwa in our life. O people of faith, fear Allah and believe in His Messenger, and He will grant you a double share of His mercy, provide you with the light to walk in on Judgment Day, and forgive you. For Allah is all-forgiving, most merciful. In simple terms, taqwa means to always be conscious of the presence of Allah in every action we take in our lives, to have fear of Him at all times. This would strive us to do good actions, while also preventing us from going close to wrongful ones. Another way we can receive the mercy of Ar-Rahim is by listening to the Quran carefully and with our undivided attention. As mentioned, when the Quran is recited, listen to it attentively and be silent, so you may be shown mercy. It is also important that we only rely and turn to Allah no matter what, meaning that we turn to Allah if we are placed in a hopeless situation or if there is a problem that we are facing. If Allah inflicts harm on you, no one can remove it but Him. And if He tends good for you, no one can turn His bounty away. He grants His bounty to any of His servants He wills. He is the most forgiving, the most merciful. We should also incorporate this attribute in our du'as by saying, Ya Rahim, forgive all my sins. Bestow your mercy upon me. You love to forgive, so please forgive me. Make me more forgiving and merciful.